Hey crafters, it's Janet with Crafting It Up in Creation. So coming at you today, I have kind of a large Dollar Tree haul. This is actually two or three different trips that I have made since probably a week after Christmas even, but I wanted to share with you a few things because I've got some craft projects that are getting ready to come up, and I wanted to show you some of the different things that I've gotten. Plus they have Easter, Valentine's Day, and a little bit of St. Patrick's Day stuff out now. So now this little wreath form is kind of like a staple at the Dollar Tree. They always have them. I made a wreath last year using the car cloth over it to make like a furry wreath. But since I have so much of that faux fur left over, I wanted to use that on one of these. And then I picked up some little butterfly stickers. They've had these for quite a while now as well. They always come out with just a little bit different ones, but I love purple. So I had a hard time walking away from these. I love the little 3D effect that they have with them. And I want to use them maybe in my planner and add them to like a little paper clip or something. I thought that would be really cute. And then this says Our Adventure Fund. I absolutely love the finish on this. Like, I love that shabby look or the farmhouse look to it. And just the finish on it is really pretty, the background paper. This is the second one I've bought because I just like it so much that I don't want to change one of them. So I thought I'd get one to where maybe I could take the Our Adventure Fund part off and maybe do something a little bit different. I love using those, you know, like shadow boxes and stuff as well. And then these little mirrors have been out for a little while. They have this really cute circular round shape. This one says Be Your Own Kind of Beautiful. And really nice to put in a kid's bathroom if you definitely wanted to leave it just as it is. And it's really, I like it. But I thought these would just be perfect to use or have in your craft arsenal to kind of upscale or do something a little bit different with them. So I did get two of them. This one said, the world is made of beautiful things like you. And I thought these are just cute little sayings, kind of lift up your spirits. I think I'm definitely going to put one of those in my daughter's bathroom. And then I did pick up a few things on clearance. So who would know that they would have these on clearance? And I never could find these before Christmas, but I love the red and black check. If they had, I would have picked up as many as they had, but I only could get two. Because I would have loved to have had these for next year to give out to like patients for Christmas. But I love the little stockings. And of course, I love the buffalo check. You know, as you can see, the red and the black. I mean, the black and the white and the red and the black sitting there. So I really, really like those. I wish I could have found more of these. If I would have found them even before Christmas, I would have loved to have done something a little more special with those. I have seen a few people use these for other projects, so picking these up is such a good idea, you know, no matter what time you can find them. And then I was very fortunate enough, again, to find some more of the little DIY ornaments, but this is the disc shape. It's kind of the long or the oblong round disc shape, and I absolutely love these. I think a dollar for these is such a steal because these are the larger ones. At Michael's, I found some of the smaller ones, and they work good depending on what you're going to use them for, but these larger ones are perfect for those angel wings that the Dollar Tree had. And then I found these pointed, slanted, and flat edge tweezers, and I was like, oh, mini tweezers, I love that. I have bought a little purse, or like a little, it looks like a coin purse, but it has all kinds of different stuff in it. It's like the old days when you used to use nail polish for to stop your pantyhose from running, to a little sewing kit, to an alcohol wipe, to one that kind of wipes off your hands. And this is what the little kit looks like. And I had thrown in a pair that I had, but they were kind of oblong and just almost a little bit too long, but it would kind of stretch out and fit in there. But I was like, oh, this will keep that from messing up the little bag. And I just thought, I love this little thing. Like, it has a ton of little stuff in it. And of course, all three of these could actually fit in that little case, but I just love that. I thought it was really cute. I got that at our Peebles locally. And then I picked up another one of these little silicone facial mask applicators. I'm gonna use this in my craft room just for hot glue or for resin or anything else. I already picked up one for that, but some of my craft stuff is upstairs and some is downstairs, so I thought it would be nice to have one in each spot, and then I don't have to go looking for it. And then I picked up this little pack of wood pieces. These include a ladybug, an owl, and butterfly. You get two of each. I really wanted it for the owls. I have a little craft in mind that I saw on Pinterest, and I wasn't sure I had any of the 5-pack of owls left from before Thanksgiving, because I used a lot of those in a little craft project then. So I picked those up, and these are really nice, you know, for a dollar that you get 6 pieces. And then I also used the little screen guard, their tempered glass, and this fits the SX Max. I believe it fits the 11. So I picked a couple of those up. They work really well for me and my daughters. And then also this wide angle camera lens. It goes on your smartphone, but every time I see these, I try to pick a couple up. At this time, I only saw 2. I picked them up, but they make really good little Santa cam ornaments. So be looking for those for maybe Christmas in July. But I wanted to show you, you can get those at the Dollar Tree. And a lot of people are taking off that little front piece and using them on those round disc ornaments to make it look like a Santa cam. And it is so precious. Like, I love, love, love that. And if you've actually used this little lens for its intended purpose, like to do the wide angle on your phone, let me know. I'd love to know if it works. And then I have the little nurses we call the shots. It's kind of like a little shadow box with the cutout of the butterfly on the front of it. And I thought it was cute. I ended up getting this one because I am a nurse. And then I got the next one because I'm an aunt. And I thought that was really cute. It says aunts are special in our hearts. And I thought, that's so sweet. But I would love to change the saying on the inside, you know, kind of like in a remembrance of someone, because I know butterflies are used, you know, in like hospice situations. I've seen like the butterflies, like the renewed birth, you know, kind of thing. And then every time I see these foundation brushes, I've been picking up a couple. I'm hoping to have like a collection to where I have enough for color families at least, for some of my different inks for ink blending. But I absolutely love these. You know, they came out with those brushes a couple years ago and I wanted them so bad, but I just could not justify $30 for like a set of 5, you know, whatever it was when they first came out. They've brought the prices down a lot more, but you know how that goes. The crayon boxes, these hold 24 crayons. They have had the clear pink and blue before, but they had some in the green, so I picked up some of those just in case I would be in a swap and need the green ones. I know that seems kind of silly, but I like that color, and even for Christmas it would have been fun if I had seen them before then. And then this is so cute. It says this house runs on love and coffee. It's like a little shadow picture frame, and it has little plastic coffee beans on the inside of it that you can kind of roll around, but it's super cute. Gonna put that in our kitchen. And then I found the craft aisle at one of the Dollar Trees in Charlottesville, and they had the super long, I think these are 12-inch dowel rods, so I got a pack of those. And I found some more of these little wood stems, but these were a little bit different than the ones I had. Some are kind of skinny, some are fatter, and I thought these would be fun to use in fairy gardens. I picked up some of these pop dot adhesives. There's 528 pop dots in this. I'd love to find out how these work. I'm gonna try to use these soon so I can let you know. And then picked up some of these little chalkboard tags. There's 4 in there, and these are really nice. Like, I opened them up, and they are very sturdy and everything. They don't bend, and I really like them. I love that little dotted line on the outside of them. I think these will be fun to use in crafts. And then they also had these little tags that I'm not really sure what shape you would call them, except for a rectangle with the cute little scallop edges. And I also picked up a little glue and residue eraser. I've bought this in the past in my craft room. Mine pretty well looks kind of nasty by now, but it really does help pull up some of that glue residue off your projects. Finger protectors. I bought a couple packs of these. I've bought these in the past. I love using them sometimes when I can find the ones that I had for projects using hot glue. It really comes in handy, especially when you want to kind of smush something into the glue even, and to make sure it stays. And of course, I have little fingers, so I can even take these off and put one on my thumb. But of course, I have really small hands, so just so you know, that's the only way that may or may not work out for you. I have also found double-sided tape in that aisle. I thought I would go ahead and try this. It does say archival safe on the back, so I was kind of impressed with that. I'll have to try it out and see if it works as well as some of the stuff that I get from Tuesday morning. But we'll see. I have a theory that some of the same places make this. It's just different packaged. And then I've bought these little craft clamps in the past as well to use like with some of my jewelry stuff. And so when I saw these at the Dollar Tree, I went ahead and grabbed a couple packs of these. They're exactly the same as the ones I've bought in the past. And I'm sure that I paid a lot more for them than a dollar. But these come in handy in holding little things into place. You know, if it's paper crafting, I'm not so sure I would use it. It might, you know, put a place in it. And then they also had pop dot tape, which I guess is kind of like foam tape, but it's two-sided, and there's three different sizes in here. There's like a thinner, a medium, and then a larger, and I thought I'd like to try this. I love making shaker cards and stuff, so I thought that I might try it. And then they also had pop dot adhesives. This is 264 pieces in this one, but these are the little circular shapes. And like I say, I think this is an awesome deal, as long as these the adhesive on these works just as well as some of the others. But it's Crafter Square. A lot of times stuff like this works just the same. And then I picked up these little two-pack of pump spray bottles. You can add just about anything in these. I like doing the perfect pearls along with the alcohol and spraying on a project, but we'll see how this sprays. I'll have to let you know. And I picked up these little mini gel pens. I love making post-it note holders, and the little tinier gel pens to add to those are a lot of fun. These are scratch art. I looked all over for these before I found them. I thought this would be fun just to try out. There's quite a few in the package, so we'll see how it works. And then I also picked up this little light up pen. It's really cute. I pulled it out for the video to see if it works, and it worked great. The little hearts light up, and it's so super cute. But since then, I've went back and picked it up, and they don't light up anymore. So I don't know if it's just not making a connection. I kind of need to look at it, but buyer beware. It doesn't light up anymore, and you do screw the end of it in order to get the pen part to come out, because the clicker part is what actually turns the little hearts on and off. Super cute idea. It might just be a user error. And then I picked up a pack of three brushes for a dollar. I think that this is an awesome deal. And for somebody who sometimes forgets to rinse their brushes out, it's nice to not pay that much for them. They also have this As Seen on TV shimmer bracelet. It's kind of like one of those little slap bracelets. I thought it was really cute. It's purple and blue sequins. And then I picked up this little love sign. It's pretty good quality. I actually like it. The only thing I think is the O is a little bit small, but it would be fun to add maybe one of the little hearts to it to use as the O, or make it even stand out a little. But I thought this was really super cute, and for coming up for Valentine's Day would be a lot of fun. And then I found chalk writer. They're just chalk markers, and I thought this would be fun to use. I think a dollar a piece is a really good deal. And I went through and I picked up all the different colors I could find. So I got white, purple. There's this really pretty gold. I can't wait to try that one out. A green one, and then a silver one. I thought the gold and the silver would be kind of fun. I like to make little signs at craft shows using those, and you know, whatever that you're displaying. And then I picked up a couple of these little screen protectors for like an Apple Watch. But I can't say the first one that I've tried, I didn't like it. It didn't seat right, and it was the 40 millimeter one on mine, and I didn't really like it that well. So I'll have to try another one. Maybe it was just the way I applied it, but it looked like it didn't sit well on the corners. Let me know down below if you've tried them. And then I picked up a couple little birdhouses. I thought that these would be fun to even use for fairy gardens and different things for the summer. I did use some of these in my Christmas crafts, and they had the little trays, so I picked up a couple of those. I just got the plain one for this one because it sits completely flat, but I thought it would be fun to add some stuff into these as well. I love how they have all that wood stuff now at the Dollar Tree. It's kind of fun because you can't get it for a dollar anywhere else. And then they had these little like tags, but look how thick this thing is. It looks like it's three different ones stacked up together. And this one was a star, and I picked this one up. I'm not exactly sure what I'm gonna do with it, but, and then this one was kind of like tag shaped, but look, it's just as thick as that one. They're kind of heavy, you know, for what it is. And I'm not exactly sure what I'm gonna use for those, but I really like them. And these are little border stickers, and they've got pearls and like little jewels. And they only had this color. I picked up two packs of these because I thought, man, that would be fun to add to the border of something. So we'll see. Didn't have anything in mind, but I thought they were really super cute. And they've come out with some really cute dog and cat toys at the Dollar Tree. My daughter has picked up something very similar to this at PetSmart for the cats, and they love it. And I thought, let me get a different one. You know, so either you can stack it on the one she has, which hers I think is like three deep, or at least two cats could play at the, well, she's got three, three cats, but somebody could be playing on one and somebody could be playing on the other maybe. So they seem to really love it. Either that, or I may even just donate this to the shelter. I also picked up a couple other cat toys. These have little pockets where you can add catnip into them, which I thought was really super cute. They kind of Velcro shut, so you can add it in there. And it's just a little mouse, and he's got like that really fluffy tail. And then you can hear the bell ringing. There's like a little bell inside of it. And I got that one that looks like a mouse, and this one that looks like a bird. And it's the same thing. It opens up at the bottom. It has that little fluffy tail and then that bell. So I thought that I actually think these were really super cute. They also have some fish as well. Now this has got to be my favorite find this year. Every time I find some of these clear ones right now, I'm gonna pick them up. I've already used a couple of these in my daughter's room, and she loves red. So if I go back, I might pick up a couple red ones and trade them out with her. She has a chinchilla, and sometimes the things that he takes dust baths. So every now and again, there'll be like dust on certain things. And so I thought these would be good in her room to protect it from that, but also good for me in my craft area to separate certain items, maybe even projects that I'm working on. They're maybe 7 by 11, not quite like paper size, but I really like them. And then, oh my gosh, Easter stuff is already out at some of the stores, and they have these little wood pieces that you can choose from, and they've got this really cute little silhouette of a bunny rabbit. I love, love, love him. They had carrots. I only got one pack of these because I wasn't really sure if I was going to use them. I thought even if I made a banner, you know, using them, then one pack would be enough. I got two packs of the eggs. I really like these as well. I think these would be fun to add to all kinds of different things and it just kind of have in my stash. And then they also had the cute little chickies. Anytime I found some that didn't quite have the hole drilled in them, I picked those up because I thought, I might need a solid one. They also have these cute little fortune cookies that can be used for Valentine's Day. It includes 10 fortunes, and it tells you all the little fortunes that are inside of them all. And these are pink and red. I believe they have pink and white as well. But they're really cute. They're kind of made of a foam, so they're kind of squishy. But then it has the little piece of paper that gives you your fortune. What a super fun idea for kids, though. Like, I love that. None of my kids are old enough, or they're too old for Valentine's Day now, at school anyway. I found this adhesive pearl wrap. This is so pretty. It's like just the little white pearl. It's just kind of like their diamond wrap. And I bought a couple of these. They also have it in the silver and the gold as well, and I think I may even show that here in a little while. These are little treat sacks. There's three pieces in each one. One pack has the red hearts on it, and one has the pink hearts on it. I belong to several different pages on Facebook. I even have my own under the same name, and they were putting names on those with their Cricut or their silhouette, and I thought that was really cute. And then they have these awesome socks at the Dollar Tree. These are little foxes. And my middle daughter loves foxes, so you might see her little hand up here in just a second. I think she was sitting beside me. And then they also had this little monkey face. And, you know, some of their socks are too fluffy on the inside, and, you know, you end up getting that peeling on your feet. These won't do that. They're really nice. I actually like these a lot, and they're really soft, despite looking like they're a little thinner than some of the others. But I really do like these, and they do have some St. Patrick's Day ones out as well. So there's her little hand in there. My hands are small, but hers are smaller. And she's 18, so she's full grown now. And then they have these pencil boxes out with all their new color scheme for decorating or, you know, like getting organized for the year. And I really like the shape of this. I thought this would be fun to put craft items in as well. And you could put different things in the top, but I guess you could do erasers and pencil lids in the top, and then of course your pencils actually in the box. So I got that color, and I believe I got a purple color as well, but I don't think I show it. And then I found these at the Dollar Tree. These are brush buddies. They go on your toothbrush, and four for a dollar seems like such a great deal. I love having a cover on my toothbrush. I just have this thing of flushing the toilet, and I don't know, I read somewhere where particles fly in the air and it just grossed me out. So I always have covers on my toothbrushes. I picked up these little love signs from the Dollar Tree, and I'll admit I picked up two because I really want to use the little hearts on a project. I already have something in mind. So I hope I can get these off without damaging the hearts, but we'll see. And I love that little love sign. Those are nice and thick. You can use them for something else. You can redecorate them. All kinds of different things. I love some of their signs, and then some of them I love to redo them. And then they have these larger ones that look like tags. It says, "Love is all you need," and "Happy Valentine's Day." And they both have my favorite thing on them, the little red truck and the little bicycle. I absolutely love this. Dollar Tree really knocks it out of the park on doing what is actually popular at the moment. So I'm always impressed with some of that stuff. And then now they're setting out some of their St. Patrick's Day stuff. And I picked up this cute little shelf setter. I thought this would be cute on a shelf or even a tier tray. And I really liked kind of how thick it is. It looks like little hearts that make up the little shamrock. So I thought that was super cute. And I also picked up these little pots. Now these are like little pot of gold for your little leprechaun. And I thought that was super cute in itself. But I also picked up an extra pack or two to use at Halloween, because I saw a really cute craft last year with those, and I had one set from Hobby Lobby, and of course theirs are much more expensive than a dollar. They also had some little cute socks, just like the little Valentine's Day socks. These are made just the same. I picked up actually two pairs of this one. It says love, but the little O is a little shamrock. And they had many more to choose from, but I picked up two of those and then one pair of these. This just kind of looks like the little leprechaun's outfit on your foot. And I thought that was pretty cute too. They had a few others to pick from. And then they also had their scarves out. And I thought this pattern
was really pretty. I don't usually wear scarves, but I have used these in projects before, and I've even seen them used on some of the wreaths, so I thought that this would be fun to have just for that. And that's what that looks like. It's like two different greens, a dark and a light green. I picked up a table cover for our table at work for our break room. And of course it has just the little hearts along the side of it. I wish it was just hearts all over and not solid on the top, but hey. And a little, this is so pretty. It's like a rose gold frame. And I thought this would be fun to use in a little Valentine craft. So I picked one of those up. It's like a little 2x3 frame. And they've started setting out some of their gardening stuff. I haven't seen the little windmills yet. I'm going to so pick some of those up. But this is like a little butterfly in that real pretty, a galvanized tin look. I want to find a way to separate this from the actual hook itself to use on a project. But even the little blue and purple butterfly is really cute. It looks like that would come off pretty easy because it just looks like the wires are wrapped around the back. But I do like these. I picked up two of these. And then I also picked up a little small thing. It's just the metal garden hooks. These come in handy for all sorts of different things in the summer. So I picked up a pack of those, and there's two in the pack. And I actually believe that is it for my Dollar Tree haul. I know I went through that really super quick and everything. I hope you guys are having a great week. I hope you will come back and see me again soon. Thanks so much for stopping by and spending some time with me. I hope to be having some actual Valentine's Day crafts coming up soon. I've been on Pinterest and a few other things, so I've got so many little ideas going through my head. But I hope, just like me, I hope you get a moment to craft it up. Take care. Bye.